Mamma Mia.
Finding results for Mamma Mia.
From the primo location.
It's very Greek.
Greece was incredible because it's probably the most beautiful place I've ever been in my life.
To the killer cast.
Got to sing and dance, kiss Meryl. Can't believe they paid me for it.
Every single piece of this was like a chance to do something that nobody else in the world would ask me ever to do.
Two outfits you could only wear in a musical. Take a chance
on me. Oh yeah, this is one zany, colorful set of clothes that get thrown on these folks.
And did we mention the wall-to-wall ABBA?
ABBA's music is a drug. It really can take you into this positive space in an instant.
Get ready to have a blast.
The whole thing was ridiculously fun. This is right up there in the top experiences of my life.
Talk EF Ultimate Break. Ages 18 to 29, pre-planned travel. You literally show up, pick a place, pick a time, pick a duration, and they will match you with your perfect trip. This is my tour, the Greek islands. It was so much fun. Literally, somebody booked it while I'm editing this. Congrats, could be you. First-time travelers can use the code EMMA100 and save money, because why wouldn't you want to do that? But thank you to EF so much for sponsoring this video. You guys are amazing, and let's go to Greece.
Hi guys, so I officially have been in Greece. I got to Greece. Tonight was so much fun. We landed at 10:30 in the morning and then met with our tour group and got back to the hotel at like 1 in Athens. We're staying at Hotel TRA in Athens. We had a quick team meeting and then we were meeting up at 5 to go somewhere and a bunch of people went out to the square. I was so tired because I slept like 3 hours on the plane, the neck pillow did damn squat. Went down there, explored, had dinner with our tour group. We literally ate dinner with a view of the Parthenon, like all lit up and just incredible. The amount of freedom that I feel when I'm traveling is ridiculous. I feel so carefree. Last time I traveled with EF Ultimate Break, I knew there was another influencer on the trip. Her name was Leah, we were friends. Had a friend to be like, let's go do this with, you know? So I was nervous this time around because I didn't have anyone like that. I was going completely blind, no friends, no photos, no idea. Like, I have literally already met the coolest group of girls. They're all so nice, half of them. Some of them are like where I was born. Some of them, like, I know where, like, we all know where each other goes to college and stuff. And like, they're so nice. I got a cappuccino in the lobby. Freddo cappuccino is how you order an iced cappuccino here. And it was literally only 2 euros, so I'm very happy right now. Brought this book with me because you guys know, I don't know if you would know, but I was a Percy Jackson kid growing up. Like, Percy Jackson, Heroes of Olympus, like every single witch book, like all of it. Like I read them, like period. I wanted the same like Greek mythology vibe. So I got this book called Lore by Alexandra Bracken, and so far I'm loving it. I took a risk by bringing a hardcover book traveling about it. So the fact that we're going to the Parthenon tomorrow and like the Acropolis in general just blowing my mind. I've already started reading some of the plaques and stuff and like about like the town history and like I could literally cry from excitement and I already saw it. The fact that I'm even here. Our tour guide, Yorgos, also gave us these little pouches to keep our money in, which is so sweet. He's really awesome. I was really nervous going into this because I had a buffer last time. This time I didn't. And even though like I brought my tripod to like take my own photos and like even if I made no friends, I'm happy to be. I like being alone, but I like the safety of a travel group because you just feel something goes wrong or like you want to go somewhere in a group where it's late at night, you feel a lot less stressed. I actually made friends, which is just... Okay, so here's my hotel room. We have a bed, we have my pants, we have books, and we have that tulle dress that I'm saving for later. Very comfortable bed, took a solid nap earlier. Nice TV, we're gonna check that out in a second. We have the filming setup we were just situated in. Desk with a little window, which is pitch black outside. We have this mirror, which I already know is going to be so good for outfit of the day, selfies. And here's the bathroom, very nice. We have a tub, no shower curtain, so we're showering freely for the view of the guests. And tomorrow is early wake up, breakfast starts at 6:30, tour starts at 8, and I already saw so many cats, which I would They literally come into the stores and sit in the stores, and the owner's like feeding them, but I don't think you're allowed to touch them yet. I thought about like bathing my hands in hand sanitizer and like, I might just FaceTime my cat to get my fix, but I will update you guys in the morning. When we were at dinner, I was like, okay guys, like who watched Mamma Mia to prepare for this? Who has read Percy Jackson? Like, come on team. Literally nobody. Someone goes, what's Percy Jackson? Oh my God, I was like, hey, everyone's homework tonight is to go read up Percy Jackson, take what demigod parent is mine quiz, and report back tomorrow, so. Okay, now I'm filming a very melodramatic TikTok because I wanted to be all bougie and fancy. I got this set off of ASOS and I'm in love with it, but I'm doing my skincare routine. Since I'm traveling, pretty basic stuff. Cetaphil, been loving the Drunk Elephant F-Bomb. I have my Gaucho. And then my Ole Henriksen Banana Bright Eye Cream. That's the only thing I really pack. And sunscreen. This set has shirt, shorts, pants, little bag, scrunchie, and then also eye mask. So my goal for this is I brought myself timer tripod. I want to take a picture literally like this in Santorini. Fingers crossing for a balcony in my hotel bed, something snazzy. Hi guys, good morning. So I slept approximately 3 hours last night. I don't know why. The cappuccino that I had last night had to be some sort of like jet fuel rocket drug. Like I was so awake and thinking about how excited I was, I couldn't sleep. So I got 3 hours of sleep last night combined with like the 4 hour nap, so surprisingly I feel good. Today is Acropolis day and we're going to tour the Parthenon this morning. My outfit I'm pretty proud of, I thought of it last night when I was lying in bed. We have tourist athletic chic. This top's from the Gap, shorts are airy, I'm wearing Air Force Ones, but then I'm also wearing this oversized thrifted t-shirt from ASOS. I'll thread up, of course, my fanny pack. I know I'm gonna sweat today because apparently it's incredibly hot and we're like kind of half hiking. I'm pretty proud of this outfit, not from, ow, can I stop? Hashtag EF Ultimate Break.
Hi!
Hi, I'm Grace, and I'm from Kansas.
Kansas.
Woo! Woo! We're on top of the Acropolis. We have the Parthenon. They're doing a wonderful job of taking my photos. And it's probably 160 degrees out. I have a water slide running down my back.
Oh, yeah.
Second bottle of water. Full athletic outfit.
It's so hot.
Freddo cappuccino, medium sweet.
Okay, we just got back. I'm peeling my clothes off and taking a body shower. Got to our hotel in Santorini. This is my view. I dropped my vlog camera. We do have a crack in the viewfinder, but she still works. We are going to a wine tasting in an hour. This was the travel fit, but now we're changing. We did have a 5-hour ferry. I did not sleep wink. It was from like 5 a.m. to 12, which isn't 5 hours, but we were awake at 5, if that makes sense. Here's the room. Once again, I have a 2 double beds, a lot of open space. We have a mirror. The bathroom is so cute. It's full blue tile. This reminds me a lot of Morocco. Okay, I'm very quickly getting ready because we have like 5 seconds. No, we had like 30 minutes, but like I wanted to get settled in. But we're going to a wine tasting and a village tour. The earrings are from Elsie Frida. Love them. These are so, literally so cool. I knew I had to bring them. This dress, I got water on it from washing my face and waiting for my moisturizer to dry, but dress is from ASOS. It looks like this. I really like it. My mom also really likes it. Right now we're walking. It's so windy. We're taking pictures pretty much everywhere. This reminds me a lot of Chef Shaolin, the blue city of Morocco, just because all the small streets, the vendors, the blue. So far, not any cats. I don't know if that's the Santorini thing, but I was hoping to see some cats.
It's working.
I wanted to know some more.
We'll see if I can find it, okay?
Oh my god, I'll try.
He doesn't have anything at home. It's the best.
Josh is dancing too.
Yeah, it's like 80%.
You're not sprinkling up there.
If salad in America tastes like this, I would eat it.
Okay, good morning. So today I woke up on my own and I wanted to see the sunrise because if I did this correctly, the sun should be rising right over our balcony outside. And of course I had an idea for a photo. So we're gonna check out and see if it's worth it. And then if it is, we're gonna change. And then get our tripod, which I brought. Okay, literally that's so freaking pretty. Okay, I now have to get ready and put on my PJ set, my towel and all this shit, and I'll be back in a second. This is dedication to the freaking craft, dude. I'm gonna get this little mug, which is gonna be filled with absolutely nothing because I'm not gonna make coffee because I don't even know if I can make coffee. Literal tripod, literal clicker. I've never been this more extra in my entire life. But today we're getting ready for our volcano excursion and I just know that I'm going to get fried. So I already had Sarah on my group SPF my part and now I'm putting on 45 on my face. We're first hiking around it and then we're going swimming and I think we will have the chance to put mud on our bodies. And as a skincare girly, I am very excited. So I'm wearing this hiking outfit first. I'm gonna get a farmer's tan, I know, but I think it's worth it because my shoulders won't get burned. If I get sunburned and I can't do the things on this trip later, I would literally peel my skin off and try again.
Ta-da, look at my flag. My flag towel. Honestly, I knew deep down in my soul that I wasn't gonna pack a towel even if I did try to remember. Do you think the suitcase has space for a towel? No, we're gonna bring the literal full tulle dress instead because that's an option.
Okay, Emma, I'm gonna kill her for this.
That was fun.
Yeah.
That was fun.
Okay.
Hey.
Good guy.
Wow.
You're amazing.
I know.
So we just finished with lunch. We did the volcano, we did the swimming in the volcanic mud, we put it all over our bodies. I still have some remnants on my face, I'm not gonna lie. Lunch was so good. Our waiter was so nice. He told us to come back later and he would buy us wine. And he asked for my name. So I did find a boyfriend in Greece. I saw this bag this morning when we were leaving to go on the bus. I didn't have time to buy it, but there's only one and I was so scared it was going to be gone, but it wasn't. This is a tote bag with all of the cats of Greece on it. This is actually why I came to Greece. Big mouth cat, stoned cat, seriously pissed off cat, horny cat, confused cat, shy cat, wicked, romantic cat. This is me in a tote bag. Just went and got another Freddo cappuccino down at the store, and I also got water because, like I said, everything is salty here. And I got this little strawberry tart thing that was delicious. Now I'm gonna go to the beach for a little bit, I think, and I brought a beach book just for this reason. I'm starting The People We Meet on Vacation, which everybody talks about, and I literally wanted to read it for so long, but I saved it for the actual beach in Greece. But I'm gonna charge, recharge, and then go to the beach because I'm very salty from the Aegean this morning, so. It's sunrise again, and we're taking more photos today. Okay, so camera is downstairs, but I just finished shooting this dress, the loofah dress, which I brought for this literally exact reason. I woke up at sunrise again. Don't ask me how I'm doing. Actually, sunrise was again beautiful. Dress is the moment, and that is what matters. It's nice getting content done in the morning because then I can travel and do everything that I want to do, but also have good pictures. I'm just so proud of myself for actually waking up.
Okay, good morning. So today is day number one in Paros, and we were supposed to have this really cool cruise this morning where it's like barbecue, snorkeling, like blue ass water, like a lot of fun. Because it's too windy, we had to cancel. So Yorgos arranged another little thing for us, but I was so tired and I have a kind of a little bit of work to do and I kind of need like a breather day that I decided to stay behind. So I'm having breakfast on my little ledge by myself. I don't know if anybody else stayed behind, it might just be me, but I just had a REM cycle for the first time in like 3 days, and I was so deep asleep that I knocked out like all my teeth in my dream, and I woke up thinking I had no teeth. Like, I had come to terms with the fact that I had zero teeth. I did not know what I was gonna do when I woke up. Like, these teeth, like one, two, three, gone. I don't know why I would have dreamt about teeth, but like it really freaked me out. And I got some croissants and cheese for breakfast, and I got the remnants of the water, but there wasn't a lot, so I think we're gonna have to walk into town in probably like an hour. That is what I'm doing today. I will update you as we venture off on our own. It's always a little bit scary when you're fully by yourself, but it's not horrible because, you know, you have like the backup that the group is like 15 minutes away. Plus the people here a lot of times know you're with the group, so you feel safer. But I'm gonna enjoy my breakfast and sit and try to actually wake up because my brain is really foggy, so. Okay, this is my outfit for going out in the town because I'm getting coffee and water and then coming back to edit a video. So, top is Urban, necklace is Amazon, pants are Zara, I just bought them. This is my third tote bag that I bought from Greece. It has all these cats on it. If there's a tote bag and there's cats on it, I can't say no. My number one travel tip is don't pack based on aesthetics, because whatever you think you need to buy to wear to like look good there, chances are they already sell it.
Strongest shot. I gotta hold my nose. What's
your bat? We made it to Mykonos and we've made friends, apparently. I'm a vlogger, yes. You wanna be in a vlog?
Make a video, a big video.
Yeah. So on the neck. Yes. Where does the lemon go?
Mouth. No.
My mouth or his?
No,
hey. Mine. You should. Leek is his neck.
No, stop it!
No, stop it!
Woo!
That's what I'm saying. Okay, so we're at the ferry and I got a sandwich in a bag and I'm gonna try it. I also got sticky chips, obviously a Freddo cappuccino. Please tell the class what you got. You're so excited. Banacopita. But I'm gonna try the sandwich in a bag, which expires in 4 days.
It kinda looks like just a loaf of bread.
This is what we're working with. It looks, I mean, the whole grain.
I'll stick with my spinach. Thank you.
I think it's good.
Mustard and mayo on that thing?
I think mayo. I don't know. Morning. So today is officially not even the last day. We're leaving. It's airport transfer day, which is really sad. But the good news is literally half the trip is on the flight to Atlanta. So we get there together and then we also have the same like 5-hour-ish layover for a bunch of us so we can all do dinner, which is really fun. But I just woke up and packed all my stuff. I have my big bag right there. Carry-on bag, backpack. I feel like I'm doing literal 360 and fanny pack. I have to pack that up still. We're going downstairs for breakfast. Transfers leave in 30 minutes. And then we have to deal with the whole 12-hour flight, customs. I downloaded one movie because the movie selection was low-key bad. Vlog breakfast and transfer and airport and all of it, so.